It's only visible if you know it's there. It's a special little niche. There's two major tie-off points, and it's angled like a rooftop. We're exposed out there. There's times there's 300 feet of air between us and the Earth. It's definitely one of my favorite places. Hello, Kurt 2.
Go ahead.
With you, clear to the top.
Copy.
Growing up in Wyoming, skiing's been my passion. I came to Jackson, I was in between careers, I guess. I was in medicine. I was at a point in my life where I needed more quality of life. It was 2009. My sister was living here at the time. She offered me a place on her couch. It was my first year as a tram operator. And the tram mechanics at that time, you know, I really idolized those guys. So that really intrigued my curiosity, like, what is going on up there? There's a mystery behind it almost. One of the mechanics, he just saw how interested I was and he offered me a ride. Before I knew it, I'm flying on the cables, cruising by the towers. That's all I wanted after that. I was hooked in. I was definitely a tram junkie. So I've been here since. The machine itself offers such an experience to people. The big focus of my job is to make sure things are running smoothly, safely. The crow's nest is the core of making sure the tram is safe. This tram is the heartbeat of the valley. One of the biggest challenges with our job is dealing with the elements. It can go from one extreme to the next. The elements change everything on that tram. Tram maintenance obviously isn't a one-man show. I'm nothing without the crew that's under me. So I've got Zach Hudson, he's our newest guy. He's been with us 4 years. He's got a lot of drive. Sarah Noby, she's a local gal, born and raised here in Jackson. And Sarah's got a love and a passion for that tram. And then we got Cliff Roberts, my right-hand man, and he's been in tram maintenance since 2014. I don't know where I'd be without that crew.
Car 2's flowing on lead.
E-brakes clear. Valley D, Aerial Tram, 720, Friday the 21st, we're operational. Riding on top of the crow's nest, you know, it's every day. We're up there, we're riding up one car and down the next, and we're just getting a rough auditory and visual of the entire structure. We're looking at the carriage and looking at the wheel spin and make sure everything's moving freely and sounds good. And then there's slack carriers, and that carries the slack of the haul rope. So we're looking at the rope coming off the shiv as we approach it, turn around and look at that rope load back up, and it's fast. It's done every day, one for safety and inspection, but two, we start to develop a relationship with that machine and we know what to expect.
Right now, going over tower two, I can get a good look down in the saddle. As we go by, looking at shifts spinning.
And you're listening to that tower as you go by. When you hear something abnormal, that clues you in. And the whole goal there is to pick up on something before it happens. That's also our time to shine. That's the whole point of what we do. Keep the wheel spinning. That machine, it's so massive, so there's a lot of intricacies. It comes down to millimeters when we're talking miles and miles of cable.
This counterweight's basically 240,000 pounds suspended in midair, and that's what's keeping tension on the haul rope.
So right now what I'm doing is I'm looking at high and low points, and that tells me what kind of stretch is occurring over the haul rope.
We get real familiar with the machine and its components, you know, looking at pressures, looking at temperatures, documenting them, you know, and looking at trends over time.
Okay, Vase, so we're gonna fire her up.
Nice push, Sarah. Yes, tower 2, 3, 4, 5, top rover.
Wyoming, we're known for a lot of wind. It is so impressive of how well that machine runs in the conditions that we endured. When it's getting gnarly, the pressure's on. All those upper mountain lifts are shut down because they can't sustain those high winds, but the tram is that summit access. We're still running. It's a big enough structure. It can handle above 65 mile an hour winds, depending on the direction. The wind meters are super crucial. Looking at wind speeds and direction does dictate to us whether or not we're in a safe operation.
We're going up into a storm. I gotta go to Tower 5 and clean that anemometer. Slow to 3. Zero speed.
One of the most common problems with our wind instrumentation is rime. Ice basically starts to grow and develop on steel. We can't get a wind reading because rime's all over the wind instrumentation.
How's that look, Zach?
Looks good.
Top station's getting rimed up.
32, straight out of the left.
Yeah, I'll buy that.
Rime's probably one of our biggest battles.
Mike Vase.
Go ahead.
Just so you know, T5 went out again.
For it, I'm gonna jump on car 2. Robbie, within the last 15 minutes, it's back rimed up. Not giving in, but it is winning.
Between myself and my maintenance crew, it's a collaborative effort to make things work.
Tower 5 winds are looking good, baby.
Okay, cool.
Ultimately, one of my favorite moments is going through a cloud layer, the sea of dreams.
I think it's like 8 or 9 degrees down here. Just gonna get a good carriage ride in, listening, looking at some things every day.
Sea of dreams is a temperature inversion where a cloud layer is created. Yeah, it's unique.
Woo-hoo-hoo.
And we call it the Sea of Dreams because it's almost like the valley's still sleeping. Yeah, you're kind of in a moving paradise.
Over 13 years, you know, being on this machine, and it just never gets old.
Each ride is unique. I guess for me, it's a source of sanity. There's no one around. There's nothing like looking around, everything sounds normal, everything looks normal. That's a pretty gratifying moment. Tram's my life. I love it. I love that machinery.
Look at that. That's wild.
There is some surreal moments. That's when it's like, whoa, this is pretty special. I've got it. I found what I want to do and what I love.
Hey, car 2.
Go ahead.
I'm staying with you. Clear to the bottom.